Hey everybody, I'm Steve.
And I'm Chris.
We're excited to tell you a little bit about R1 and about the problem we're solving as we work with Palantir. R1 is a healthcare revenue cycle company. Just to make that real, I bet every one of us here has been to a doctor or gotten a procedure in a hospital, and you probably paid a copay. And when you left that appointment, or after that care was provided, you probably assumed that the doctor and the health system was going to be reimbursed. So we provide technology that works behind the system to make sure all that reimbursement happens. So if you think about checking in or scheduling your appointment, registering when you arrive, after you provide service, a lot of things happen behind the scene. Your chart is coded. A claim is submitted to an insurer. There's lots of activities to follow up to get that payment. Even care is, or customer service is provided to the patient. We provide technology that does all those things. Now, I bet some of us in this room have also, maybe 6 months or more after you left the hospital, maybe got a bill that you didn't understand or had mistakes on it or that you needed to address. So unfortunately, for those of you who've had that happen, you've experienced a byproduct of some of the problems that we're trying to address in the healthcare reimbursement system.
That's right. And just to make that real for all of you, the best that we've been able to accomplish as an industry right now is for a physician who maybe owed $100 for their services, they're typically having to spend $4 just to collect that. And oftentimes, they're only collecting 95% of it. So when you extrapolate that across today's healthcare revenue, which is around $4 trillion, you're talking about $160 billion annually spent just trying to collect the revenue that the providers are owed. And oftentimes, they're only collecting around 95% of that. We think that this is completely unacceptable. It's a lot of waste. It can be optimized. It can be done better. And so as we think about where we sit trying to help providers and patients have a better experience in today's healthcare world, we really wanted to step back and say, how can we attack this problem differently and at scale? And so as we studied this problem, what our research really showed is that we were all attacking this problem in the wrong way. We were focused on task-based automations or siloed approaches. And so we started a research program to sort of understand more. What did we find?
What we found is that, that the future requires what we would call comprehensive automation. But there are challenges to achieve that. And a lot of the challenges to achieve that that are really driving just the inefficiency and complexity of the healthcare ecosystem are related to data and technology. We have disparate systems. The hospital has a system, physician groups have a system, payers have a system, clearinghouses have a system. They're not that interoperable. There's been progress on interoperability over years, but a lot of the standards for transacting data are pseudo-standards. They're not actually that standardized, and making them work is challenging. And third, when you think about the data itself, it's more complex than a lot of other situations. So for example, a medical record, these can be 300, 500 pages long. It contains not just numbers like your labs, but also long narratives, which can be quite different depending on what physician wrote it, and then also diagnostic images. And pulling all that together is required to make good decisions and do the right tasks. Moreover, there's other documents. There's guidelines from regulatory agencies. There's guidelines from payers, changing all the time. And you have to calculate reimbursement, so every health system has an agreement with an insurer, a contract, that determines how they're going to get paid. So pulling all this together to comprehensively automate and make sure the decisions and actions are accurate is a huge challenge.
And we had to approach it in a different way. So you see two of us up on stage here. He's my digital twin. And from operations and product and technology, plus Palantir, the Foundry platform, and AIP, we really think that we can attack this problem differently. And we're going to show you an example here in a second. While Steve gets the demo running, what we're going to look at here is an example of the medical coding process. Just to give you an example of how complex this is, I like to think about the fact that there are over 10,000, many tens of thousands of different codes in the ICD-10 universe. Such favorites as sucked into a jet engine subsequent encounter, burn caused by water skis catching fire, or my personal favorite, occupant injury from space collision. But as you can imagine, that multitude of ICD-10 codes creates permutations that are sort of incomprehensible, and why we needed a AI-enabled native platform to solve it.
So today, coding is a really hard job. And we started working with the Palantir team. We did a build session in December. We started engaging with them on a full-time basis in January. And so we'll show you what we've built. So our vision here is, over time, we believe that autonomous medical coding is possible, which is required to accurately bill. But we probably get there by first having a copilot that helps a medical coder. And then over time, as accuracy is validated, we then move into autonomous coding. So what you're going to see here is a coder that's looking at a queue of encounters from patients, like we went to see the doctor, and they log in. They're now looking at, on the left side of your screen there, they're saying all the detail from the medical record from this encounter. And on the left side, you can see those are medical codes that have already been pre-populated. How did this happen? Well, you're looking at here is a constellation of AI agents. That's a combination of large language models that are being applied to those guidelines that I mentioned, to the medical record, and are making decisions and interacting with one another to actually come up with the predictions. It's very important for us in our industry to have an audit trail as to why the codes were selected. And you can see here that the AI agents automatically provide to the user highlights of where, what the reasons are in the guidelines as to why those codes were actually generated. Moreover, these guidelines are important because these contain the two decades of experience we have medical coding across all our clients.
Yeah, so the real value here is about being able to couple expertise and technology that we've innovated on over, as Steve said, two decades, with the scaled approach that a Foundry platform allows us to deliver. And by providing not only the ability to automate this at scale, but also provide the audit trail, which, as we all know, with healthcare is super critical, it really enables our medical coders to work at an unprecedented scale and speed on behalf of providers and physicians. What the demo is showing you right now is just a view of how that human-in-the-loop dashboard might look and how we would know when automations are being successful at a scale where it can be deployed, and then also a view into how we might go about auditing that, whether it be for a payer denial appeal or for a governmental regular audit on the back end. So to close, we're really excited about what we view as a bold initiative to transform this industry and think about it completely differently. Coding is one space that we're working on, but with Palantir's help, we're actually focused on four main use cases that represent a disproportionate share of that 5% of revenue that's lost. And we believe there is a multi-hundred-billion-dollar opportunity here industry-wide to put that money back into the pockets of providers and physicians so that they can better invest in patient outcomes.
And we believe we have the scale to do it. We serve over 500 clients. We serve 94 of the top 100 health systems, some of which are here today. So we believe this can be a dramatic, great impact on the industry and provide better health care for all of the country. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Hope to tell you more in the future.